Hey, it's Dr. Hannah with this week's Hot Topic. Today I want to talk to you about how you find a good supportive shoe. Hopefully you're not shoe shopping solely of what the shoe looks like or how cheap it is, because if you do, then you may not be getting as supportive of a shoe as you should. And if you get something that's not supportive, you're gonna potentially open yourself up to a lot of health issues that could have been prevented if you had gotten a more supportive shoe. So today I have a couple tips that you can use next time you go shoe shopping. First thing is you want to make sure the shoe has a really good stiff back on it, so the heel should not bend into itself. If you go to take the heel and push, that heel shouldn't go anywhere, and if it does, that means you don't have really good heel support on that shoe, so look for a different one. Second thing is you want to make sure the shoe has a small amount of torque to it. The shoe shouldn't look like you're wringing out a wet towel. So again, remember your foot is going into this and you don't want a lot of that side-to-side torque, because again, it's gonna open you up to spraining an ankle, twisting it, breaking it. So you need the shoe to not twist when you're going side to side. The other thing to keep in mind is you need the shoe to bend where your toe normally bends. So if you take the shoe, you push it on the front, it shouldn't, again, fold right into each other, because it means it's not supportive and there's just not gonna bend where your foot normally bends. Again, you should, your toes, where they normally go when you walk, that's where the shoe should bend, not somewhere else. You don't want to change the biomechanics of your foot because the shoe is not supportive and it's just doing whatever it wants. The other thing to look for is that there's arch support in it. Most shoes, you can take the insoles in and out. So if you have your own custom-made insoles or insoles that you've just purchased that are just a general one, those are good ideas too, to make sure you get that extra arch support in the shoe. So that's another thing to look for, to see if those insoles can be removed to put in your own support, or if it has its own support enough. The other thing is to make sure the shoe is wide enough. Some people just think that they have a normal sized foot and they're just gonna cram it in there like whatever. It's kind of like a Cinderella thing. If the shoe is too narrow, get a wider size. If it doesn't fit you, don't get that shoe. It makes no sense to put your foot into a shoe that's gonna be really uncomfortable. Again, you're gonna set yourself up for some major health issues later on if you have a shoe that doesn't fit you. The last thing is, the first time you put your foot into that shoe, it should feel comfortable. You shouldn't really have this break-in time. Some shoes you might, like barefoot running shoes, where your foot has to adjust to it because there's different parts. But when you put your foot into the shoe, it should feel really comfortable. You shouldn't get blisters. You shouldn't feel like your foot sliding up and down. That means you don't have a good supportive shoe, and the shoe's probably the wrong size for you too. So hopefully you can take these tips the next time you go shoe shopping. And that's all I have for you this week. We'll see you next time.